When my son was 9 months old, he woke up in the middle of the night throwing up. We found out that my son had pancreatitis. And 6 weeks later, I got a letter from the city saying during the time that my son almost died, our water was contaminated. And it would only impact the very, very young and the very, very old.
I'm a mother of two. I'm from Norfolk, Virginia. And just a few years ago, I found out that Norfolk Southern was my neighbor. They left a highlighted paper on my door stating the air that you're breathing is contaminated.
I have been working with some mothers that live in a public housing community in Norfolk, Virginia, and they are experiencing flooding. The children would have to walk in about thigh-deep water to get to school. Instead of sending their children to school soaking wet, they just keep them home. Every day of instruction is valuable, and when you lose a day every other month, it just sets the children back even further. There are talks of cutting the EPA. There's a lot of information that we need that the state wouldn't be able to provide us.
To me, it just sends a message as you're not good enough. You don't live in these areas, you don't have the money, we're not here for you.
We need the EPA more than ever. Climate change is real and it's here. The EPA is there to assist and to lead to prevent further climate disruptions.
The decision makers need to know that the EPA is our last line of defense against the things that can kill us and our children.